Murder at Whitechapel by Jack Harding.
An all grisly scene in the streets of Whitechapel. Another harlot has been sent to hell. People are shocked every time at these instances, but no one knows who the killer is. The investigation is going to be conducted by London's police chief, Rob Stanton. He is in his 50s and can be grouchy, but has a good record for solving complicated murder cases. He wasn't expecting to have a female colleague from the north, especially a young, inexperienced one who has just received promotion.
Good day, I'm Alicia. You must be the chief, Rob?
Yes, I am. Who are you?
I've just become a detective, and I've come to London to continue my training. I'm sort of worried that I might get homesick, but hopefully everything will go to plan.
Well, if you want a tip, there's always something going on here to keep you busy. We've just had one of the most horrendous murders in Whitechapel, down the back alley behind the White Horse Inn.
Oh my, are you exaggerating?
Well, if you think a dead woman with a slit throat, abdominal mutilations, removed internal organs is exaggerating, you should seek help.
That's unexpected, even for a murderer. I think we should get started right away.
Well, to be honest, it's hard to be shocked. After seeing murder for 30 years, but seeing a body that someone's chopped up like a butcher would disturb even the devil himself.
I hope that we're able to catch the monster who's killing and butchering these innocent women.
This fellow must really hate prostitutes. The murders reported were all of women who sell themselves.
Yeah, they may be the poorest of the poor, but they are women and they don't deserve to be slaughtered like this.
We should get going.
Yes.
And so, Alicia and Rob take the underground train to Whitechapel. The air is completely tainted by the ghastly steam of the trains. The journey takes 20 minutes. Alicia is silent. She doesn't want to think about the mutilations of the woman in the street and the organ removal. When the train stopped, they were the only ones that got off. Would you go to the streets of a murder scene?
This is the goddamn street, lass.
Do you have to put it like that?
Well, this is the scene, like the devil's living room. But if I'm putting you off, I apologise. So be prepared to be shocked.
Well, I'm shocked already.
Alicia and Rob arrive at the dank alley of the murder scene. The air is cold and musty with the smell of stale beer and tobacco. The strumpet's corpse was laid half in the gutter with a slit throat and a mutilated abdomen. Many other organs were missing.
I'm glad we haven't had breakfast. This is the worst thing I've ever seen.
I guess we have to investigate.
Yes, it's very clear that this murder was extremely messy and excessive.
I've just thought of something. Maybe this murderer kills tarts because he thinks they're impure and he removes their organs to get rid of their impurity.
Good theory, but lacks evidence. You need to prove it.
The two examine the alley and look for a possible murder weapon, but don't find anything other than a doll in a bin with blood on it. They question the landlord of the White Horse Inn, who said that he had not seen the victim, but said that he had heard a scream and a struggle very late the previous night. They look at the body and find that it is unclear what killed her first, but they concluded that it involved some physical beating and the slit throat confirmed that she had bled to death. They then decide that the killer had cut into her body and removed some of her organs after she died. They think that the killer could have used a fish knife as the body was neatly cut and the organs were precisely removed.
The killer might have used a fish knife to do this.
Yes, I agree. It seems like the killer took the weapon with him.
I'm not 100% sure, since there is no hard evidence of what type of knife was used.
After waiting for the body to be removed by a medical examiner, they decided to go back to the police station and to look over the few pieces of evidence that they managed to find, like the doll with the blood they found in the bin and the broken glass.
I have organised a team of officers to question the local fishmongers to see if they have any reports of fish knives being stolen.
Good idea. I think we should also question the restaurants, as my brother works in one and he always says he works with fish knives.
You're actually quite smart, lass, but we should do one thing at one time.
Thanks. Do you find multitasking hard?
Looking at the doll, it's likely that this is the victim's blood. We can't be sure. There is no hard proof. The broken glass could also have been used as a murder weapon, as it has always had blood on it.
It's so frustrating that the evidence is a little on the lacking side.
A few minutes later, the police station receives a letter in the post addressed to Alicia.
What's this? It's a little big for a letter. It's more along the lines of a small package.
What is that?
I don't know, it just came in the post. Do you think that you have a letter opener?
Yes, it's in the drawer just over there.
Alicia opens the letter and is horrified to see a human liver. She also sees a note which reads, "Dear Miss Alicia, I've noticed that you're trying to catch the Whitechapel murderer and have made little progress. I have to say that death fascinates me. The concept of our conscience being non-existent and going to eternal peaceful suffering. But at the same time, I love to look at the science that makes us alive and what stops the body working. For that, I have removed organs for several Whitechapel women for my collection and analysis. Yours truly, Dr. Jack Durham."
Hey, Rob?
Yes? What is it?
I think we definitely have a new lead now.
Written and produced by Jack Harding. Directed by Jack Harding. Narration by Jack Harding. Alicia, played by Jess Chantak. And Rob, played by James Allinson.